suggest things like feeling depressed and thinking, why bother putting my seat belt on, or being obese and not being able to fit it. So, I mean, what does the Ministry of Transport do if you start to look at issues like that?
There are a combination of high risk factors, you're absolutely right, and people who are drinking and driving are more likely not to be wearing a seatbelt, or teens who are not wearing seatbelts are more likely to be drinking and using drugs. So there is research being undertaken right now by the New Zealand Transport Agency to identify why these people aren't wearing their seatbelts and how we can best get them to start wearing them, because we really want to bring down the deaths and serious injuries on our roads. We just don't want this number of teenagers being killed on the roads.
So if you were brought up like me, I was brought up in a rural area, brought up in the Marae. A lot of times we don't wear our seatbelts because we're in kind of rural areas. I feel like that it affects then going into like cities and
nations
and, you know, outside of our communities, that, you know, that like they're so used to not wearing them that it doesn't apply to them, because I feel like nothing's going to happen to me. You know, we're
Okay, Alex, can you just raise your hands up in the air? Okay, just go through the emotions as if you're kayaking.
We definitely need to target rural areas, certain rural areas, like this road, for example.
Okay, and can you try and take it off or not?
Fatalities that related to not wearing seatbelts.
I don't think so.
To buy yourself.
We need some local champions, you know, to get out there in the community.
And enforcement, how would you enforce that?
Okay, you're struggling, aren't you? Big stuff.